Well, it's that time of year again when the tide is at its highest. Climate scientists were in our area today gathering data about flooding and measuring high tide in the region. They call it the Catch the King Citizen Science event. Aisha Tolliver had a chance to check it out.
King Tide was here. It's one of the highest tides of the year in the fall when the moon is closest to the Earth. Executive Director of Wetlands Watch, Skip Stiles, says the waters peaked around 11 a.m.
Normally with a king tide, this water would be only about a foot higher. With the wind from the north that we're getting today, it'll probably be about 2 feet higher.
Stiles says a lot can be learned from this event. Each year since 2017, when the king tide comes, they host the Catch the King Citizen Science event, where volunteers gather data about flooding.
We're basically mapping where the king tide goes. We're mapping where the flooding goes.
Volunteers use a sea level rise app on their phone to leave GPS pins that mark how high the water is at its peak. From there, researchers and scientists can use that information for studies and flood mitigation plans.
For researchers, what they're able to do is test their models out. If they're predicting where the water is going to go, this helps them prove it. For planners like City of Norfolk, this tells them, hey, this intersection floods, and it floods exactly in this space, so when we fix it, we've got to fix it so that we cover all that area.
Stiles says not much has changed about the high tide over the past few years, but they do have a lot more data on the extent of flooding than before. In the future, he hopes to expand the measurements outside Hampton Roads.
There are teams on the Northern Neck up along the Potomac River. Our goal is we're having the app rebuilt. It'll be out in a couple weeks. We want to take it into the rural coastal areas because they need mapping to put their plans together.
In Norfolk, I'm Aisha Tolliver, 10 on your side.